Blackstone presents How Are We Still Married? Volume 1 by Beth Albright and Ted Ishler.
The audiobook is performed and hosted by Beth Albright and Ted Ishler.
Where to begin?
Well, let's just start with the basics. I'm Ted.
And I'm Beth. We've been married for 35 years.
And because
we met when we were five.
Right. We've moved like 35 times.
At least. We're in the crazy media business. I'm a women's fiction novelist, and I was an actress on Days of Our Lives and a radio talk show host.
Whoa.
I know, so impressive.
Well, you see, I'm a TV creative director and was an on-air TV news reporter and a comedy writer on Candid Camera and some other things. Lots of them.
That's kind of impressive.
Yes, of course.
But just kind of. We met in New York City.
And we live in Southern California now, but between then, we've made a few stops in Alabama, Mississippi, back to Alabama, Baltimore, Cleveland.
L.A., Kansas City, Phoenix, twice, back to Kansas City, Houston, Nashville.
Back to L.A., San Francisco, L.A. again, back to Phoenix.
Milwaukee and Southern California again.
Yeah.
I think Southern California has been five times.
I think so. I think we've got a trend there. And somehow we haven't killed each other yet.
Amazing. But it's been so close. Our amazing son is what keeps us sane.
So after all these moves and career battles and ridiculous messes.
Enormous messes.
Absolutely.
We can't wait to tell you. We still love each other though, right? Right?
I had to think about that. But yes, of course, that's why we're here and to figure it out with you.
Because how are we still married?
Okay. So everybody has always told us that we have so many crazy stories and just...
They're ridiculous. They're not just crazy.
Life.
It's just ridiculous. Nobody does what we've done. And nobody would ever still be married on this. No way.
I wouldn't. That's why everybody always says...
We almost aren't, actually.
After we talk to people, it's always like, well, how are you still married? So it's like, okay, well, that's a good idea for a show. So somebody else can help us figure that out. And everybody can let us know if we should still be married. Maybe how about that?
No.
We've stuck it out this long. We're gonna
It's been a really, really, really long time. 37 years as a couple.
Okay, well, if you set it up that way, then we got to go back. So this
New York City college dorm.
Like so here's the thing: we were both in this program called Junior Year in New York.
It was my program. You just got in.
So we were both at different schools. I was at the University of Kansas at the time. Beth was at the University of Alabama.
Roll Tide.
And we both applied for this program called Junior Year in New York at Hunter College, and we both showed up there.
He was supposed to be coming with a girlfriend.
Yes.
And she backed out at the last minute.
She backed out at the last minute. And so we were all meeting at the very first time. We lived in New York City. And then basically the idea was you go to school at Hunter for a year and then you get internships in the arts or whatever.
Or the media business, which we were both in. And our internship happened to be at the exact same place, CNN. And he thought he was my boss. And that's where the problem started.
Well, as it should be.
Uh-huh.
We met for the first time. I remember sitting around this big circle of all the people that were in our program and looking around like, oh, there's a cute girl over there. She has an awful lot of makeup on, but she's very cute. Everybody else is like in sweatpants.
I was beauty pageant ready. What are you talking about?
Of course. Being from Alabama, that's the way it is. But
And you know what I thought about you? My God, he's so big. He doesn't even fit in this desk. Look at those enormous feet.
What kind of guy?
What kind of guy is that?
Yeah.
But then you played the piano. And that's my soft spot. It's
like, that was it.
I remember saying, oh my God, why did you have to make him play the piano? Because then I was gone. I was just gone. That was it.
That always does it. That's my go-to move.
Well, it worked.
So
Prior to that, there were issues at CNN.
Everybody's given their internships. And so I had the internship. We were both on the assignment desk at CNN, which was... A weird thing it was actually in the World Trade Center.
Our love life started in the World Trade Center.
Yeah, I guess that should have told us something.
Yeah.
But so it was like in the bottom level of the World Trade Center, one World Trade Center, I think.
It's a lobby. It was right off the lobby.
So you take the escalator down and then you're sort of down in there. And so I had the morning shift is what I recall.
Correct.
So you were off
at 1 o'clock.
So Beth wasn't there yet.
I came in my first day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I was there in the morning. You answer phones. You just do all the stuff that nobody wants to do.
We're lowly interns from
crazy people and all that kind of stuff, and do that kind of work. And then, so I was done.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.